My name's Envelope from Columbus, Ohio. My mom calls me Tony, and I'm with Weightless Records.
Come home after a long day's work, put my feet up, unbutton my shirt.
Kind of got my start just in high school. You know, everyone pretty much rapped. That was kind of what you did. So probably when I was around like 15, 16, Columbus had a pretty good scene as far as it's like open mics, people in like the high school halls. Just kind of went from there. There's like Weightless was going on, Megahertz, you know, RJB2, all those people. So I was kind of just sitting and watching all those people. I don't know, fate had its way. I came up with the name Envelope pretty much because I liked the way it sounded. I think there was a guy named like Radioactive or Radio somewhere. I don't think I ever even heard him rap, but I just, people were calling him Radio. And I was like, man, I like the way that sounds. So I was just trying to think of something with like a similar amount of syllables. And the name means absolutely nothing, but it's funny because I get people like every other week coming up to me like, oh, I just figured out your name, like the Envelope, because you're white. So I'm like, there's no meaning behind it, man. There's nothing. But if you want to find meaning and send it to me, that's cool. Maybe I'll adopt it.
Dollar dinner, like politics is something we all can in, and now they're using my state as a poster child. Envelopes back at it again. They let them out.
The album meant significant anthem. I was pretty pleased with it. I produced it all with Amos Famous. I'm really into working with an album with one producer because I feel that's the best way to get like a cohesive sound in an album. That's pretty much just what I was going through at the time. I was getting drunk, getting arrested, trying to scheme my way in the girls' bedrooms. You know, my random, periodically getting pissed off at society and politics. That's pretty much it. I felt like I kind of made a few insignificant anthems where they were like my little standing on a soapbox, but still not the most important thing in the world. So with Shark Bolt, it's being produced by Blueprint. We've known each other for, I don't know, close to a decade now, but this is probably the first project we've ever worked on. And just a lot's happened to me since my last album, and it's pretty much just trying to sum all that up without, you know, while staying focused. The idea too, the shark bolt, is kind of like getting ate by a shark and a lightning bolt. It's just kind of like there's so many different things in this world that'll kill you, and there's so many different things that are trying to kill you, and just kind of finding the humor in it, I guess. And just, you know, K-I-M, gotta keep it moving.
Back of this cop car trying to listen, and the two officers decide my condition.
Well, it's the A to the B, sipping on lean, catch me in the cup. As far as like my sound and some of my influences, I'd say I pretty much, in my formative years, I was like a kind of East Coast rap head. The like phrase keep it real and all that was constantly going around, and everyone pretty much, you know, in their music, whether it's like Mobb Deep or Wu-Tang or J-Rue the Damager or Gangstar, they pretty much talked about like being real and being yourself. So when I started like rapping, I didn't want to just emulate them and talk about like, you know, being in the hood in New York, because that wasn't me. What I learned from them was more just to kind of like be yourself and just to be as kind of honest, like, yeah, I have a day job. I roll my pants up, you know, like I smell on occasion, I'm balding, but like I figured that was my version of keeping it real, I guess. And that's kind of what I go for. And I always try to keep the sound, like musically in the production I choose, try to keep a warmer and more melodic sound, I think suits me. Kind of covers up the fact that I'm usually offbeat and little other things, but I'd say that's my sound, man.
For whack, we ain't that tolerant. We say we don't just to state the obvious.